iPhone 11 with dual rear cameras, Apple A13 Bionic Soak, Liquid Retina Display launched. Price, specifications. iPhone 11 price in India starts at ₹64,900 and the phone will be offered in three storage variants. Apple on Tuesday unveiled the new iPhone 11 smartphone as a successor to the company's iPhone XR. According to the Cupertino, California-based company, iPhone XR was its biggest-selling smartphone in the 2018 iPhone lineup, and with iPhone 11, the company is making things even better on its cheapest new iPhone. In addition to the iPhone 11, the company also showcased the new iPhone 11 Pro and iPhone 11 Pro Max phones that will sit at the top end of the company's smartphone portfolio. Notably, Apple will retain the iPhone XR in its lineup. iPhone 11 price in India. Apple iPhone 11 price will start at ₹64,900 in India and at $699, roughly ₹50,000, in the US for the base 64GB variant. The phone will also be offered in 128GB and 256GB variants that will retail at ₹69,900 and $749, roughly ₹53,600, and ₹79,900 and $849, roughly ₹60,800, respectively in India and the US. The iPhone 11 will come in 6 colors: purple, white, green, yellow, black, and red, and its pre-orders will open September 13th in US and over 30 countries around the world. The sales will begin September 20th in the first batch for countries and September 27th in India. Apple says iPhone 11 is jam-packed with great new abilities and features, including the brand new dual rear camera setup, spatial audio, Dolby Atmos support, and improved battery life. As we mentioned, Apple will retain the iPhone XR in its lineup despite unveiling its successor, and it will be priced at $599, roughly ₹43,100. iPhone 11 specifications. iPhone 11 features a 6.1-inch Liquid Retina display and is powered by Apple's new A13 Bionic chip. Apple claims that the A13 Bionic Soak brings the fastest CPU and the fastest GPU present in any smartphone to the iPhone 11. iPhone 11 runs on iOS 13 that brings features like dark mode, sign-in with Apple, and expanded haptic touch support. Among the biggest improvements in the iPhone 11 over the iPhone XR are the camera capabilities. The iPhone houses a dual camera setup on the back that packs a 12-megapixel wide-angle main shooter with f1.8 aperture and optical image stabilization and a 12-megapixel secondary ultra-wide-angle shooter with f2.4 aperture and 120-degree field of view. New camera software features include next-generation Smart HDR, improved night mode, and enhanced portrait mode. Additionally, the dual rear cameras support 4K video recording at 60fps and are paired by 36% brighter flash than the one in iPhone XR. The front shooter on the iPhone 11 is also a step up over the iPhone XR. Apple has included a 12-megapixel front shooter that is capable of shooting video in 4K as well as SLO-mo videos. It offers a wider output if you switch to the landscape mode. In terms of the battery life, Apple claims the iPhone 11 will offer 1 hour more than iPhone XR on a single charge. To give you a reference point, in our review, iPhone XR easily lasted a full day and the phone went on for over 13 hours in our HD video loop test. Apart from the Apple iPhone 11, the company also introduced the new iPhone 11 Pro and iPhone 11 Max smartphone. Apple iPhone 11 upgrade, the good, the bad and the ugly. Yesterday, Apple unveiled the iPhone 11 alongside the two iPhone 11 Pro models. Its predecessor was Apple's best-selling phone, so it has big shoes to fill. Despite the clever naming change, the iPhone 11 is the successor to the iPhone XR and not the iPhone XS. It has a lot in common with the iPhone XR and brings a number of improvements. But it also failed to bring some expected upgrades and actually has a downgrade or two. So let's take a dive into the iPhone 11 and see which is good, which is bad and which is straight up ugly. The good. The Apple iPhone 11 packs Apple's latest 7nm chipset, the A13 Bionic. While chipsets like Qualcomm Snapdragon 855 Plus, 7nm, and Samsung's Exynos 9825, 7nm, have closed the gap to the Apple A12 Bionic, it's still the most capable chipset on a smartphone. The A13 will push Apple's lead in processing power even further. The iPhone 11 gets a new main camera, 12MP f2.4 ultrawide. Some people would have preferred to have a telephoto instead of an ultrawide, but most would pick the latter for its ability to pack more into the frame and offer a dramatic perspective. And at 13mm, Apple's ultrawide is very close to Samsung's 12mm one, which is noticeably wider than other ultrawide cameras on high-end phones. There's also a new selfie camera. The 12MP f2.2 selfie snapper can record 4K video and has a slightly wider field of view. The Apple iPhone 11 is now IP68 water resistant, which translates into the ability to survive under up to 2 meters of water for 30 minutes. The iPhone XR was IP67 1 meter for 30 minutes. Better battery life. Apple claims 1 hour more than the iPhone XR, which is already lauded for its endurance. But at least the iPhone 11 is slightly cheaper. In the US, the base 64GB model is now $699, down from the iPhone XR's $749 of last year. Colors: the iPhone 11 comes in black, yellow, product red, white and the new green and purple, though we are sad for the missing blue. The bad. The screen of the iPhone 11 is the same 6.1-inch 828x1792p LCD of the iPhone XR. At this price you could have a 1440x3120p AMOLED with 90Hz refresh rate. However good the liquid retina of the iPhone 11 XR is, it feels distinctly outdated in 2019. The base storage is 64GB. It's past time Apple made the base storage at least 128GB. These are not cheap phones and you can find devices that cost half as much and still have more storage in their base versions. The 2-year-old notch. This exact same sized notch has been around since the iPhone X, which came out in September of 2017. Apple has made Face ID better and fitted the notch with a better selfie, selfie camera since then, but it remains one of the biggest display cutouts around. The ugly. The iPhone 11 still uses a Lightning connector, which is inferior to USB-C in both speed and abilities. Nearly everything nowadays uses the better and universal USB-C, even Apple's own iPad Pros and MacBooks. It was time to bring Apple's breadwinner device into the fold. The ugly camera module. The iPhone 11 Pro might have an excuse for the messy setup because it needed to fit more rear cameras. We've seen better solutions there too though. Yet the vanilla 11 has a dual setup not unlike the XS and XS Max and still moved to the square module. The 5W charger in the box. The iPhone 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max ship with an 18W capable charger in the box. The iPhone 11 ships with the comical 5W one, despite having support for 18W fast charging. But hey, if you're in the US, you could use that $50 saved from the entry price to get an 18W charger. The outlook. There's a reason the iPhone XR is selling like hotcakes. At its lower than the Pro's price point, the iPhone 11 is the cheapest entry into the world of current-gen iPhones and many people will be happy to shell out $699 per €799 per £729 for a 64GB iPhone 11. And most of the people that won't buy the iPhone 11 will buy a discounted iPhone XR, which might still be a win for Apple. iPhone prices cut in India. Here are prices of iPhone 11, iPhone 11 Pro and new prices of older phones. Apple will bring the iPhone 11, 11 Pro and 11 Pro in India soon with prices starting at ₹64,900. Meanwhile, Apple has dropped the prices of older iPhone models in India. Apple has revised the prices of older iPhone models in India. The company has dropped the prices of the iPhone XR, XS and XS Max that were launched last year as well as older models like the iPhone 8, iPhone 8 Plus and iPhone 7 Plus. The new prices have been listed on Apple's website and are expected to come into effect soon on e-commerce platforms and via Apple authorized resellers. Starting with last year's iPhone models, the iPhone XR is now available starting at ₹49,900 for the 64GB storage option. The iPhone XS 64GB model will be available for ₹89,900, iPhone XS Max 64GB variant is priced at ₹89,900 and the older iPhone X will be available for ₹91,900. iPhone XR 64GB, ₹49,900, iPhone XR 128GB, ₹54,900. iPhone XS 64GB, ₹89,900, iPhone XS 256GB, ₹1,03,900. iPhone X 64GB, ₹91,900, iPhone X 256GB, ₹1,06,900. Going back further, the iPhone 8 price in India has now dropped to ₹39,900 for the 64GB base model, while the iPhone 8 Plus starts at ₹49,900. The iPhone 7 Plus is even lower at ₹37,900 while the iPhone 7 will be available for ₹29,900. iPhone 8 64GB, ₹39,900, iPhone 8 1128GB, ₹44,900. iPhone 8 Plus 64GB, ₹49,900, iPhone 8 Plus 128GB, ₹54,900. iPhone 7 Plus 32GB, ₹37,900, iPhone 7 Plus 128GB, ₹42,900. iPhone 7 32GB, ₹29,900, iPhone 7 128GB, ₹34,900. As for Apple's newest iPhones, the iPhone 11 is the most affordable among the three new models with a starting price of ₹64,900 in India. The iPhone 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max start at ₹99,900 and ₹109,900, respectively. The iPhone 11 models will be available in India starting September 27. iPhone 11 64GB, ₹64,900, iPhone 11 128GB, ₹69,900, iPhone 11 256GB, ₹79,900. iPhone 11 Pro 64GB, ₹99,900, iPhone 11 Pro 256GB, ₹13,900, iPhone 11 Pro 512GB, ₹31,900. iPhone 11 Pro Max 64GB, ₹109,900, iPhone 11 Pro Max 256GB, ₹23,900, iPhone 11 Pro Max 512GB, ₹41,900. Man miraculously catches falling iPhone 10 on roller coaster ride. Nothing ruins a day out at a theme park quite like dropping your pricey $1,000 phone while riding a roller coaster. Unless there's a guy like Samuel Kempf sitting behind you, that is. Kempf recently shared a video showing how he snatched a dropped iPhone 10 out of midair, all while riding a roller coaster at speeds of 130 km per hour. I was in Spain at Port Aventura on Shamhala ride and saw the person a few rows ahead drop their iPhone 10, he writes. Long story short, I caught it. This roller coaster is moving at over 130 km/h. It was once Europe's tallest and fastest coaster, only recently beaten. Since being posted late last week, the video has already racked up more than 5 million views. Sadly, it doesn't show the eventual reunion of iPhone dropper and their beloved handset after the roller coaster ride. However, Kempf spoke to the New Zealand Herald about the interaction. He couldn't believe it, he gave me a big hug, he said. The funniest reaction was when we had got off the roller coaster and you go down to look at the photos and videos they take. Half the people there seemed to be watching our screen and then everyone started cheering and clapping when it happened. Kempf, who hails from New Zealand, was in Europe representing NZ in the fistballing, similar to volleyball, World Championships. iOS 13 releases on September 19, iPadOS will be available month-end, features and eligible devices. Apple's official website reveals iOS 13 will be coming to iPhones on September 19, while iPadOS will release for iPads on September 30. With so much going on, the company did not spend a lot of time talking about the new software updates and when it would release its new operating systems for the iPhone, iPad, Apple Watch and Mac. Luckily, Apple has mentioned the timeline on its updated website, which now reveals that iOS 13 will be officially released on Thursday, September 19, while iPadOS will come to iPads on September 30. Apple first announced iOS 13, iPadOS, watchOS 6, tvOS 13 and macOS Catalina at its WWDC developer conference a few months ago. Since then, Apple has released public beta builds for its new operating systems. Next week, Apple will release the stable iOS 13 for iPhones on September 19, which is a day before the iPhone 11 releases. iOS 13, iPadOS and watchOS 6 eligible devices. iOS 13 will be available for iPhone 6 and later models all the way to iPhone XS Max. The new iPhone 11, 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max phones will ship with iOS 13 out of the box. iPadOS is a new dedicated operating system for the iPad and will be coming to iPad Air 2 and later models, all iPad Pro models, iPad 5th generation and later, and iPad Mini 4 and later. The new 7th generation 10.2-inch iPad will come with iPadOS out of the box. Apple has also announced that watchOS 6 will be available for Apple Watch Series 3 and later on September 19, while Apple Watch Series 1 and 2 will get the update later this fall. The company has not announced a specific date for the release of macOS Catalina, but it plans to roll out it in October. iOS 13, iPadOS and watchOS features. A big feature coming to iOS 13 and iPadOS is dark mode, which turns the background of the UI deep black or gray. On OLED iPhones, dark mode will help conserve battery life. iOS 13 and iPadOS will also be big on privacy features such as location tracking protection and sign-in with Apple. iOS 13 also brings swipe-supported keyboard, redesigned Apple apps like Reminders, Mail, Music and so on. iPadOS is a forked version of iOS 13, designed to offer better functionalities on the iPad. With iPadOS, you will see a redesigned home screen with the Today widget now available on the main page, improved multitasking experience with split view and the ability to switch between multiple apps using slide over. iPadOS also brings external drive support in Files app and other iOS 13 features as well. Meanwhile, watchOS 6 will bring a dedicated app store, which will allow users to install apps directly on the Apple Watch without having to install them via the iPhone. watchOS 6 also brings new watch faces that includes gradient face, digital face, solar face and California dial, as well as new health and fitness features. Apple Launch Event 2019. Apple Arcade will launch on the 19th of September at ₹99 per month. While Apple Arcade may not rival cloud gaming subscription services like Nvidia GeForce Now, Google Stadia, and Microsoft xCloud, there's more to this gaming platform than meets the eye. Apple's new gaming service will help users play games across the iPhone, iPad, iPod Touch, Mac, and Apple TV devices. Apple Arcade features a library of over 100 games from popular and indie developers, which aren't available on any other mobile platform or subscription service. Unlike game streaming platforms, Apple Arcade will allow you to download games and play them online or offline. Apple also demoed gameplay for a couple of games that will be available at launch, Frogger in Toy by Konami and Shinsekai Into the Depth by Capcom. While both demos were played with touch controls, iOS 13 also supports Xbox One and PS4 controllers. The Apple Arcade gaming service will be available on September 19th in over 150 countries. The subscription will cost only ₹99 per month in India with a one-month free trial. The subscription will give users access to a catalog of 100 new games at launch. No gaming service has offered that many games at launch. The App Store will also feature a new arcade tab. The new tab will be updated with new games every month and provide recommendations for users. Players will also be able to watch game trailers and get access to expert editorial content, like sneak peeks and game guides. Considering its ₹99 per month price tag, the Apple Arcade gaming service seems like a pretty sweet deal. Apple will oversee new medical studies focusing on women's health, hearing, and mobility. Apple revealed on Tuesday that it is going to oversee three new medical studies in fields ranging from women's health to hearing technology, using data from customers with Apple devices who choose to participate. The announcements continue Apple's expansion into the health space, with initiatives ranging from medical studies to medical hardware and apps. It has hired dozens of people to its health team in the past 5 years, including doctors, engineers, and scientists, but has also recently seen departures from its top ranks over differences in opinion. The health team's leader is a high-ranking executive. The company's chief operating officer, Jeff Williams, and CEO Tim Cook has said that Apple's advances in health will be its greatest contribution to humanity. The company's vice president of health, Sambul Desai, made the announcement on stage at Apple's annual fall hardware update, where it also announced a slew of updated products, including a new version of the Apple Watch and three new iPhones. Customers will sign up for the studies using a free Apple Research app that will be available to download later this fall. Apple's new studies cover the following. Women's health. The company has been gradually adding new features associated with women's health monitoring in mind ever since 2014, when it got pushback from users when it announced its HealthKit service without reproductive tracking. It recently hired an obstetrician, signaling an interest in the space. According to Apple, the goal of the study is to study whether patients are at risk for common conditions, such as polycystic ovary syndrome, infertility, and osteoporosis. It will be conducted with Harvard's T.H. Chan School of Public Health and the NIH's National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences, NIEHS. Hearing. The goal is to study how sound exposure affects hearing over time, which is a relatively novel area of focus for technology companies. Apple said it is working with researchers at the University of Michigan. Mobility. It is also looking at how walking pace and steps climbed relates to heart health, quality of life and other factors. That research will be conducted in partnership with Brigham and Women's Hospital and the American Heart Association. The studies indicates Apple's interest in these areas, but doesn't necessarily mean that it will release new products that cater to them. That might depend on the outcome of the study and whether there is a potential to impact patient outcomes with the Apple Watch or devices. The wearable space is still nascent, and studies are underway to measure whether these devices can do more than helping generally healthy people stay fit. This isn't Apple's first foray into medical studies. Its health team has already commissioned research with collaborators at Stanford University into how its smartwatch technology can monitor the heart. This Apple Heart study helped spur the company to release an electrocardiogram app and sensor in the Apple Watch to detect signs of heart rhythm irregularities. It has also announced studies on disease areas like autism and Parkinson's disease. All of these studies involve a research partner at an academic institution. Apple is far from the only technology company building a team in healthcare. Alphabet has numerous groups focused on the medical sector, including Verily, its life sciences unit, and Microsoft is building out a team to focus on areas ranging from medical research to artificial intelligence. Apple rival Fitbit has previously worked with academic partners on both women's health and for research into how patients who reach milestones related to steps and activity levels can recover more quickly from common surgical procedures. Apple Watch Series 5 launched along with iPhone 11, starts at ₹40,900. Apple has launched the next iteration of its smartwatch, the Apple Watch Series 5, that is powered by its watchOS 6. Apple Watch Series 5 was launched alongside the launch of the Apple iPhone 11 series. Apple on Tuesday, September 10, upgraded its smartwatch lineup by launching the Apple Watch Series 5. The Apple Watch Series 5 is powered by the latest version of the company's watch operating system, watchOS 6, and it features some major upgrades over last year's Apple Watch Series 4. Apple Watch has become the most advanced and most loved smartwatch in the world, Apple CEO Tim Cook said on the occasion. The Apple Watch Series 5 is powered by watchOS 6 and it comes with a new always-on display feature which displays time and complications, or in simple words, your vitals all the time. It comes with an LTPO display that dynamically switches between a screen refresh rate ranging between 60Hz to 1Hz for saving power. The newly launched smartwatch comes with a bunch of new sensors and drivers including an ambient light sensor, a power driver and a power management integrated circuit. This new system would allow the Apple Watch Series to deliver 18 hours of battery life. The Apple Watch Series 4 successor also comes with a compass and a new compass app that will tell users details such as their latitude, longitude and the direction in which they are heading. Apple also introduced new safety features for its Apple Watch Series 5. In addition to featuring features like fall detection, medical ID and emergency calling, the newly launched Apple Watch comes with a new international emergency calling feature that is available in 150 countries across the globe. In terms of colors and variants, the Apple Watch Series 5 is available in gold, space black and black color variants. This year the company has also introduced new brushed aluminum and brushed space black variants. In addition to that, Apple has also introduced new Nike and Hermes models in new color variants and leather color options. The GPS variants of the Apple Watch Series 5 starts at $399, ₹28,700 approx. The cellular models of the Apple Watch Series 5 start at $499, ₹35,900 approx. In addition to this, Apple also announced that the company was keeping its Apple Watch Series 3, which now starts at $199, ₹14,300 approx. In India, the Apple Watch Series 5, GPS, starts at ₹40,900. The GPS Plus cellular variant of the Apple Watch Series 5 comes at a starting price of ₹49,900. The GPS, GPS Plus cellular and Nike variants of the Apple Watch Series 5 will be available in India soon. Apple hasn't announced the exact date of availability yet. As far as the Apple Watch Series 3 is concerned, the GPS variant of Apple Watch Series 3 will now sell in India for ₹20,900. The GPS Plus cellular color variants of the Apple Watch Series 3 will now be available for ₹29,900. The Apple Watch Series 3 will get watchOS 6 update on September 19th and Apple Watch Series 2 and Watch Series 1 later this year. Facebook warns about iPhone privacy change that could unsettle Facebook users. Less than 2 weeks before a likely iOS software update that will give iPhone users regular pop-ups telling them which apps are collecting information location in the background, Facebook has published a blog post about how the Facebook app uses location data. The blog post appears to be a way to get out in front of software changes made by Apple and Google that could unsettle Facebook users given the company's poor reputation for privacy. Your Android or iOS location settings allow you to control when you share your device's precise location with apps like Facebook, a Facebook engineering director wrote in a blog post. That's why we're letting you know that Android and iOS have released new versions of their operating systems, which include updates to how you can view and manage your location. iOS 13, the forthcoming version of the iPhone software, will provide a pop-up that informs users about how many times an individual app has used background location over the past few days. Background location can be useful for many apps like Maps or for Facebook functions like check-ins, but it can also be abused by app makers to collect data against the wishes of its users. That means that some Facebook users may soon be confronted with an Apple-created pop-up telling them that Facebook has used their location in the background some number of times over the past few days, and including a map marking where Facebook asked the phone for its coordinates. If you are using iOS 13, you will begin to receive notifications about when an app is using your precise location in the background and how many times an app has accessed that information, according to Facebook. The notification will also include a map of the location data an app has received and an explanation why the app uses that type of location information. Sharing your location with a third-party app can really enable some useful experiences, but we don't expect to have that privilege used to track us, Craig Federighi, Apple's senior vice president of software engineering, said at the time. He said that Apple would enable a feature that allows iPhone users to provide location privileges just one time, instead of when the app is in use, never, or always, the previous options. If you do choose to grant an app the ability to continually monitor your location in the background, we will give you reports so you will know what they are up to, Federighi continued. The Facebook blog post also addressed Android, which also has new location features in its latest version, 10. If you decide to update to Android 10, you'll have the option to allow individual apps to access your precise location, either while you're using the app or when you're not, according to Facebook. Facebook and Apple representatives didn't immediately return requests for comment. Facebook's blog post also added that it might collect location information through alternative methods even if users turn off location settings on their device. We may still understand your location using things like check-ins, events and information about your internet connection, according to Facebook's blog post.